It is time now for Better Money, and joining me now is Joel Johnson. He's a certified financial planner and managing partner of Johnson Brunetti. He's going to tell us three financial tips that we can start today. Thank you for being with us, Joel.
It's great to be back, Kara. And, you know, with all the time we've spent at home, many of us, we're thinking about the future. We're thinking about retirement. Even if we're retired, we're wondering if we're doing the right thing. So we want to give you some tips today, some things to watch out for also.
Number one, first tip, the crowd is usually wrong.
Do not stake your financial future on popular opinion. It's really, really important because there is this theory, even investing, it's called the odd lot theory. And what professional investors do is they go against the crowd or the individual investor, because the individual investor, the big horde of little guys out there, to use a firm, is usually going in the wrong direction. So we want to be careful about getting advice by popular opinion. The crowd is usually wrong in many areas, and certainly when it comes to investment planning.
So time, you say, is our most valuable commodity.
Yeah, and this is one of the things where, you know, I wrote a book called The Wealthy Think Differently, and the wealthy look at time differently. They think that time is more important than money. So it's no longer driving 3 hours to save, you know, a dollar or two. It's about, hey, that's 3 hours of time that I'm using to save that dollar or two. Maybe my time is more valuable. So it's really important that we look at that, especially those of us that are still working. How important is your time? What is your time worth? Don't do, you know, $10 an hour activities with your time if your time is worth $50, $60, $100 an hour.
Yeah, and that means you can't underestimate, you say, paying more for value and convenience. I think of it like online grocery shopping. To me, it's so worth that $6.95 service fee to have it delivered.
Exactly. I mean, my business partner said, his wife came to him and said, how much would it be worth to you if you never had to walk into a grocery store again? And that's exactly what they were doing, was signing up for the online grocery shopping. I say to clients, sometimes we do these workshops, I say, how many of you drove a bicycle here tonight? And of course, nobody raises their hands, but that's the cheapest way to get to a restaurant, is riding a bicycle. So sometimes we disconnect and we don't pay for valuable services. We don't want to cut when we go find a lawyer or an accountant. We don't want the cheapest accountant, and you shouldn't be looking for the cheapest financial advice either. So make sure you're paying for value and you get the value that you're paying for.
And you have an offer to help people learn more. It's called The Wealthy Think Differently, a book you have there. So for more information and to request your copy, go to bettermoneytv.com.
Yeah, I wrote the book last year, Kara, and it's really important to have in this day and age with all that we're going through.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Joel.
Thank you, Kara.
And that's Better Money.